Welcome to the operating system lecture, module 1, part 2. Objective of this lecture is to familiarize with different types of computer architectures and the various types of operating systems used in these architectures. The topic that are going to covering in this lecture are, first topic is different computer architectures such as single processor system, multiprocessor system and distributed system. The second topic is the different types of operating system. The various operating system we are covering in this lecture are simple batch operating system, multi-programmed batch operating system, time sharing system, multiprocessor system, desktop system, distributed operating system, real-time systems, open source operating system and network operating systems. Let us start with the first topic, computer architectures. Operating systems have been evolving through the years. These operating systems have been closely tied to the architecture of the computers on which they run. So, before going into the type of operating system, let us have a briefing on computer architecture categories. First one is single processor system. This system has only one CPU capable of executing general purpose instruction set. Also, there are other special purpose processors present to perform certain device specific tasks such as keyboard controller, which accepts the characters into the system that are typed by the user. Also, there is a display controller that manages the display on the monitor, etc. The second category architecture is multiprocessor system. From the name itself, it conveys that it has two or more processors in close communication, sharing the computer bus, memory and peripheral devices. Since there are multiple processors, these processors can do multiple tasks simultaneously. Hence, more work done in a shorter period of time, which increases the throughput and reliability of the system. The third category is the clustered system. In this type of system, two or more computers are clustered together to perform certain tasks. The details of these systems will be seen in the coming section. There are two category multiprocessor systems, that are asymmetric multiprocessing and symmetric multiprocessing. In multiprocessing, the use of two or more central processing units within a single computer system. In symmetric multiprocessing, two or more identical processors are connected to a single shared main memory that have full access to all input and output devices. The figure shows that CPU 1, CPU 2, CPU 3 are the three processors, and the processors are P1, P2, P3, which are stored in a shared memory. The asymmetric multiprocessing has the master-slave relationship among the processors. There is one master processor that controls remaining slave processors. The master processor allots processors to the slave processors. From the figure, it is clear that memory is not shared among processors in asymmetric multiprocessing. This table shows a comparison on asymmetric multiprocessing versus symmetric multiprocessing. Asymmetric multiprocessing system has a master-slave structure. Hence, all processors are not treated equally in asymmetric multiprocessing system. But in symmetric multiprocessing, all the processors are treated equally. In asymmetric multiprocessing, tasks of the operating systems are done by a master processor. But in symmetric multiprocessing, tasks of the operating systems are done by individual processors. There is no communication between the processors in asymmetric multiprocessing because the processors are controlled by a master processor. While in Symmetric multiprocessing, all processors communicate with another processor using a shared memory. Asymmetric multiprocessing are cheaper compared with symmetric multiprocessing. While symmetric multiprocessing systems are costlier than asymmetric multiprocessing. Asymmetric multiprocessing is simple. Only one processor, that is master, can access the data structure. Hence, it is easy to design the asymmetric multiprocessing systems. While symmetric multiprocessing is complex as the data structure is shared among all the processors and all processors need to work in synchronization. In asymmetric multiprocessing, in case the master processor fails, a slave processor is turned to master process to continue the execution. But in symmetric multiprocessing, if a processor fails, the computing capacity of the system gets reduced. Next category architecture is distributed systems. A distributed system means it is a collection of processors or computers that do not share memory or a clock. In this system, each processor has its own local memory. The processors in this system are connected through a communication network. In distributed system, users get access to all the resources that are connected with different computers. Hence, access to a shared resource allows computational speed up, increased data availability, as well as enhanced reliability. Now we can move on to the type of operating system. Some of the most widely used types of operating systems are single user, single task system, simple batch system, multi-programming batch system, time sharing batch system, multiprocessor system, desktop system, distributed operating system, network operating system, and real-time operating systems. Now, let us see the first category operating system, that is single user, single task. As the name implies, this operating system is designed to manage the computer so that one user can efficiently do one thing at a time. That means it allows single user to perform only one task at a time. The functions like printing a document, downloading images, etc. can be performed only once at a time in this operating system. The Palm OS for Palm handheld computers is a good example of a modern single user, single task operating system. The second category operating system is simple batch operating system. In this type of system, there is no direct interaction between the user and the computer. That is, an operator acts as an intermediary between the user and the computer. Here, the user has to submit a job written on cards or tape to a computer operator. Then computer operator sorts the program with similar requirements into batches and places a batch of several jobs on an input device. Then a special program called monitor manages the execution of each program in the batch. On completion of programs from each batch, the output from each job would be sent back to the appropriate programmer. The figure given here shows the representation of simple batch operating system as well as the memory layout. Here there are four users submitting jobs to the operator. Then the operator groups these jobs into two batches and submit to the computer for execution. Now, let us see some of the disadvantages of the simple batch operating system. Since the user submits job to the operator, there is no interaction between the user and the computer. That is, the main disadvantage of simple batch operating system. The second disadvantage is poor CPU utilization. That is, CPU sits idle while the program does the IO operation. The third disadvantage is, in batch operating system, the programs are grouped into batches as per the resource requirement. Hence, there is no mechanism to prioritize the processes based on the priority. This figure shows the representation of an early batch system example. Here, in step A, programmer brings the cards containing the program into system 1401. In step 2, the system 1401 reads batch of jobs onto a tape. And in step 3, the operator carries this input tape to the system 7094. In step B, 7094 system does the computing. And in step E, the operator carries the output tape to system 1401. And in the final step, the system 1401 prints the computed output. Next is multiprogramming batch system. We have seen that in simple batch operating system, a single program cannot keep CPU and IO devices busy always. Multiprogrammed system provide an environment in which the various system services, system resources such as CPU, memory and peripheral devices are utilized efficiently. In this system, OS keeps several jobs in memory simultaneously. If several jobs are ready to run at the same time, then the system picks up and begins to execute one of the jobs from the memory through the process of CPU scheduling. Once this job needs an IO operation, OS switches to another job. In multi-programmed system, there are moments when the CPU sits idle and does not do any work, for example, during the IO operation. In multi-programming system, CPU will never be idle and keeps on processing. Hence, resource utilization is better in multiprocessing system than simple batch system. But like simple batch operating system, multiprogramming batch OS also do not provide user interaction. Next is time sharing system. Time sharing systems are very similar to multiprogramming batch systems. In fact, time sharing systems are an extension of multiprogramming system. It is also known as multitasking. Time sharing requires an interactive computer system which provides direct communication between the user and the system. The user gives instruction to the OS or to a program directly using input devices such as a keyboard, mouse, touchpad or touchscreen and waits for immediate results on the output device. Accordingly, response time will be short. In time sharing system, the prime focus is on minimizing the response time. While in multiprogramming, the prime focus is to maximize the CPU usage. Quick response is achieved by giving fair execution opportunity to each processes by two means. First one is round robin scheduling. In round robin, services all processes by turn. Second is time slicing to prevent a process from using too much CPU time. This figure shows the representation of a time sharing system. A time shared operating system allows many users to share the computer simultaneously. As the system switches rapidly from one user to the next, each user is given the impression that the entire computer system is dedicated to his own use. Even though it is being shared among many users. The advantages of time sharing systems are quick response and reduces CPU idle time. Next is multiprocessor operating system. It consists of several processors that share a common physical memory. All processors operate under single operating system. In this system, several processors can be executed at a time. That means each processor can be assigned to a different processor for its execution. Hence, more work done in a shorter period of time. If possible, the system divides tasks into many subtasks, and then these subtasks can be executed in parallel in different processors, thereby speeding up the execution of single tasks. Multiplicity of the processor and how they do act together are transparent to others. The advantages of multiprocessor systems are, first is it provides higher computing power and speed. Hence, it enhances the performance of the system. Second is increased throughput. That is, execution of several tasks by different processors concurrently increases the system throughput without speeding up the execution of a single task. So far, we have seen 5 different types of operating systems. To avoid the confusion, now let us have a comparison on the 3 category operating systems that are multi-programming, multi-processing and multi-tasking. As we have seen, multi-programming operating system means a computer running more than one program at a time, like running Excel, word processor, email, web browser, etc. simultaneously using single CPU. Then what is multi-processing? Multi-processing means a computer using more than one CPU at a time, and all these CPUs share a common memory for the execution. Next, the term multitasking. In multitasking, multiple tasks sharing a common resource. The resources can be a CPU or a memory or any other I/O devices. We have seen multi-programming shares common CPU among multiple programs, and multi-processing shares common memory among multiple CPUs. But multitasking shares all sort of resources among multiple tasks. But the difference is they share the resources in a timely manner. Hence, it is also called time sharing system. Another difference of this category is multiprocessing occurs by means of parallel processing, whereas multiprocessing as well as multitasking occurs by switching one process to other. The phenomenon is called as context switching. Next operating system type is desktop operating system, that is personal computer operating system. Personal computer operating system means it is a control program in a user's machine, that is desktop or a laptop. It is also called a client operating system. PC operating systems were neither multi-user nor multitasking. But the goal of multi-user or multitasking operating system is to maximize the resource utilization. But in PC OS, instead of maximizing CPU and peripheral utilization, the systems opt for maximizing user convenience and responsiveness. Some of the dominant PC OS include PCs running Microsoft Windows, Linux and Apple Macintosh. Microsoft microcomputers were immediately able to adopt some of the technology developed for large operating systems. Hardware costs for microcomputers are sufficiently low that individuals have sole use of computer and CPU utilization is no longer a prime concern. Some of the OS designs used in mainframes may not appropriate for small systems such as desktop PC systems. Next is distributed operating system. This figure shows the structure of a distributed system. In this structure, a number of autonomous computers were interconnected through a communication network. And the distributed operating system is a software over a collection of independent networks communicating and physically separate computer nodes. A distributed OS provides the essential services and functionality required for an operating system, but adds attributes and particular configurations to allow it to support additional requirements such as increased scale and availability. Next is distributed operating system. Distributed operating system is one of the important types of operating system. As we have seen, distributed systems comprising of many computers that are interconnected by communication networks and automatically share job processing load. Distributed operating system provides coordination of operations and information flow among computers. It allows programs to run on several processors at the same time. Processors communicate with each other through various communication lines. Users need not be aware about where their programs are located and run. These systems are also known as loosely coupled systems. The main benefit of distributed systems is its low price to performance ratio. Now let us see the advantages of distributed systems. As there are multiple systems involved, with resource sharing facility, a user at one site can utilize resources available at other sites. This system also provides fault tolerance, that is, if one site fails, remaining sites can continue operating. It also provides fast processing and better service to the customers. Since tasks are distributed, less load on host machines. The two types of distributed operating system used are, first one, client-server system, and the second one is peer-to-peer systems. Now let us see what is a client-server operating system do. As shown in this figure, client-server is a network architecture in which each computer or processes on the network is either a client or a server. Servers are powerful computers or processes dedicated to managing certain tasks such as disk drive management, which is called file server, printers management, which is called a printer server, or a server which does the network traffic management, which is called a network server. Now let us see some more details regarding the functionalities of client server systems. Server systems can be broadly categorized as compute servers and file servers. The compute server system provides an interface to which a client can send a request to perform an action, for example, reading of data. In response, the server executes the action and sends the results to the client. A server running a database that responds to client requests for the data is an example for such a system. And next is a file server system provides a file system interface where clients can create, update, read and delete files. An example of such a system is a web server that delivers files to clients running on web servers. Next category is peer-to-peer computing. This figure shows the peer-to-peer model. In this model, peers are computer systems which are connected to each other via internet. Files can be shared directly between the systems on the network without the need of a central server. Peer nodes can act as a client as well as server to other nodes on the network. That is, in this model, clients and servers are not distinguished from one another. Instead, all nodes within the systems are considered peers, and each may act as either a client or a server depending on whether it is requesting or providing a service. In a client-server system, the server is a bottleneck, but in a peer-to-peer system, services can be provided by several nodes distributed throughout the network. To participate in a peer-to-peer system, a node must first join in the network of peers. Once a node has joined the network, it can begin providing services to and requesting services from other nodes in the network. Skype is an example of peer-to-peer computing. It allows clients to make voice calls and video calls and to send text messages over the internet using a technology known as voice over IP, that is VoIP. Skype uses a hybrid peer-to-peer approach. It includes a centralized login server, but it also incorporates decentralized peers and allows two peers to communicate. Next is real-time operating system. A real-time operating system is an operating system intended to serve real-time applications that process data as it comes in, typically without buffer delays. Applications need to complete its computational task in a timely manner. The RTOS is used to implement a computer application for controlling or tracking of real-world activities. It is defined as an operating system known to give maximum time for each of the critical operations that it performs, like OS calls and interrupt handling. A real-time operating system must have well-defined fixed time constraints, otherwise the system will fail. The key factors in a real-time operating systems are minimum interrupt latency and minimal thread switching latency. A real-time OS is valued more for how quickly or how predictably it can respond than for the amount of work done it can perform in a given period of time. This figure shows the structure of Ekronos RTOS. Ekronos RTOS is used in modern critical systems such as medical devices and car braking systems. Real-time system is defined as a system in which job has deadline. Job has to finish by the deadline strictly. Hence, real-time OS is more frequently dedicated to a narrow set of applications. Some of the applications of RTOS are embedded systems, industrial control systems, robots, and air traffic control systems. Real-time systems are systems in which correctness of the system depends not only on the logical results of the computation, but also on the time at which the results are produced. There are two category real-time operating systems. First one, hard real-time operating system, and second is soft real-time operating system. Let us see what is hard real-time operating system. The RTOS, which guarantees the maximum time for critical operations and complete them on time, are referred to as hard real-time operating system. Hard real-time operating system is a system whose operation is incorrect, whose result is not produced according to time constraint. If a result is delayed, huge loss may happen. A hard real-time system is very restrictive and safety is critical. Example of hard real-time operating system applications are air traffic control system, medical system, that is where telesurgery is doing, a satellite launch, railway signaling system, etc. Next is soft real-time systems. The RTOS that can only guarantee a maximum of the time, that is, the critical task will get priority over other tasks, but no assurance of completing it in a defined time. These systems are referred to as soft real-time operating systems. Soft real-time system is a system whose operation is degraded if results are not produced according to the specified timing requirement. A soft real-time system is less restrictive and safety is not critical. For example, computer games, virtual reality, etc. With this, we can conclude that the late answer is a wrong answer in a hard RTOS, while a late answer is acceptable with degrade in a soft RTOS. That is, an RTOS that can usually or generally meet a deadline is a soft real-time OS. But if it can meet a deadline deterministically, it is a hard real-time OS. Therefore, we can say that the chief design goal of RTOS is not to achieve high throughput, but rather a guarantee of a soft or hard performance category. Next is open source operating system. Open source OS are those available in source code format rather than a compiled binary code. Linux is the most famous open source operating system, while Microsoft Windows is a well-known example of the opposite type, that is closed source operating system. Apple's macOS X and iOS operating systems comprise a hybrid approach. They contain an open source kernel named Darwin, yet include proprietary and closed source component as well. The advantages of open source operating systems are they are allowing anyone to inspect the source code, and those with sufficient technical knowledge can customize the OS and fix problems as they arise by delving into the source code. It also allows the development of open source operating system to be community-led or at least influenced, with technical users suggesting changes to an open source operating system's code base. Next is network operating system. A network operating system is a computer operating system that is designed primarily to support workstations, personal computers, and in some instances, all the terminals that are connected on a local area network. Also, a network operating system is a specialized operating system for a network device such as router, switch, or firewall. Network operating systems can be embedded in a router or hardware firewall that operates the functions in the network layer. The role of the network operating system is to then provide basic network services and features that support multiple input requests simultaneously in a multi-user environment. Operating systems with a network stack allowed personal computers to participate in a client-server architecture in which a server enables multiple clients to share resources such as printers. The software behind a NOS allows multiple devices within a network to communicate and share resources with each other. Summary of this lecture is, in this lecture, we have studied various computer architectures such as single processor system, multiprocessor system, distributed system, and their functionalities, advantages, disadvantages, and applications. Then we have studied different types of operating systems such as simple batch operating system, multi-programmed batch operating system, time sharing system, multiprocessor system, desktop system, distributed OS, RTOS, open source OS, and network OS that are used in this various computer architectures. Then we have studied their functionalities, advantages, disadvantages as well as applications. These are the references. Thank you.